What in the world is an entomologist like me, George Brossard, looking for among the old sets of the Ouarzazate Film Studios in Morocco? The backdrop for such famous movies as Lawrence of Arabia and Gladiator.
I'm looking for the star of our show.
I'm not looking for Peter O'Toole or Russell Crowe, but for a more dangerous character that has the respect of all who know him. When this merciless predator attacks, he has the sting of a jet fighter. As with many other film stars, people either love him or hate him.
He is our star, the Scorpion.
The Scorpion's ancestors were almost 3 feet long, with gills that allowed them to breathe underwater. With their jointed legs, they became the first invertebrates to venture onto dry land over 450 million years ago. Today's scorpions look almost exactly like their distant ancestors, except that they are much smaller. Of course, as land creatures, they no longer need their gills. Scorpions are not insects. With their cousins, the spiders, they form a separate category of animals, the arachnids.
Surprisingly, it's in the vast arid parts of the world that we find the greatest variety of scorpions.
There are over 1,400 species of scorpions divided into 9 main families. To learn more about this ancient and venerable creature, the feats it can perform, and its amazing ability to adapt, we are going to the heart of the world's largest desert, the Sahara. For hundreds of years, countless travelers have passed, like this, through the gates of the Mehamed Kasbah before setting out in the Moroccan desert. This is where you find your provisions, good camels, and experienced camel drivers. But if you were interested in scorpions, you only need one name, Mr. Abdul.
Salam alaikum, salam alaikum. Monsieur Abdul? Abdul?
This man is highly respected in the community. He is a guide, a healer, and a scorpion charmer. He is intrigued by my plans for a hunting expedition. This must be the first time a tourist has asked to visit places crawling with scorpions. Finally, we embark on our scorpion hunt. Around us is an almost hallucinatory landscape, the Erds, or Great Sand Dunes. Unfortunately for our little caravan, the Chargui is blowing. Every spring, this powerful wind blows down from the continent, raising sandstorms that can last for days at a time. There's no way we can see scorpions under these conditions. Scorpions hate the wind. The slightest breeze interferes with their incredibly precise detection systems. Scorpions that live in the dunes, on the other hand, are well equipped for walking.
Their legs end in long claws and are covered with hairs that increase traction and prevent them from sinking into the sand. Humans are not nearly as well equipped for walking in sand. We sink and slip at every step, and the going is pretty rough.
Mr. Abdul urges me on. Just a few more dunes, and we will find shelter. I can't wait to breathe something besides dust. At last, this is the base camp of our expedition. A big Tuareg tent set up amid the dunes. Our camels have worked hard, and I am relieved that they can now have a rest. They deserve it. Abdul wastes no time. His first act is to place a metal amulet at the entrance to our tent to protect us from scorpions. It is important to place the scorpion with its head facing up. Otherwise, there's no guarantee it will work. When conditions improve, scorpions come out of their burrows. Don't be fooled. The scorpion is busy hunting, even though it doesn't seem to be moving at all. It is instantly alerted to any victim, like this larva, that foolishly ventures too close. The scorpion is equipped with all sorts of detection devices that are pure marvels of sensitivity and precision. These little hairs on its pincers can sense the slightest movement in the air around it, even the flutter of a butterfly wing. The scorpion's legs are equipped with organs sensitive enough to detect the low frequencies produced by an insect moving along the ground. Each leg becomes a radar device pointing in a different direction. Together, they sweep a 360-degree radius around the scorpion. As soon as its prey appears, the hunter turns towards it to detect the high-frequency vibrations of the approaching insect. Guided by this infallible system, the scorpion's pincers never miss their target. In general, scorpions do not waste their venom. They sting only when their prey is too strong to overwhelm them, using only their pincers. Overnight, the wind has died down. The horizon is no longer blotted out by clouds of dust and sand blown up by the storm. What a treat to finally see the beautiful scenery all around us. Mr. Abdul is waiting for me on a dune not far from our camp. He believes that a scorpion hunter needs much stronger protection than a mere talisman. I'm going to take part in a ritual that Abdul learned from his father. The ceremony begins with a confrontation. The scorpion is sprinkled with Catran, an anti-scorpion potion prepared from a selection of plants. The healer blows on the scorpion and orders it to surrender. ER Durs, the Scorpion, and all its brothers not to sting me. Abdul's magic also transfers part of the Scorpion's power directly to me. And I am sure going to need it, because now I am off to dig up some Scorpion burrows. I'm going to in the Larada, a section of the desert with scatterings of dirt mounds and shrubs. This is an ideal habitat for our scorpion friend. Many scorpions spend almost 95% of their life deep in their burrow. I don't blame them. The surface temperature of the sand can reach 150 degrees Fahrenheit, whereas at 3 inches underground, it might be a comfortable 80 degrees Fahrenheit. When it comes to humidity, it's even better indoors. When it is 5% at the surface, it can be as much as 70% 8 inches down. We can recognize a scorpion burrow by the shape of the entrance.
As you can see, the oval-shaped opening allows the animal to penetrate the ground without having its pincers in the way.
Scorpions put a lot of energy into excavating their burrow. Some species move up to 400 times their weight in dirt. I hope I don't have to work that hard. The burrows are generally 6 to 8 inches deep, although some can be 3 feet deep. The scorpion often digs a spiral tunnel. Which helps keep the temperature and humidity stable.
There it is. There it is. As you can see, burrowing scorpions have large, big pincers.
Some species weigh only a fifth of an ounce, but can pick up a weight of 200 times that with one pincer. Their short legs and strong mouth parts are ideal tools for digging and maintaining their precious burrow. These scorpions almost never leave their hiding place. They just wait until supper arrives and then simply seize it in their powerful pincer. We might be right in the middle of the desert, but I have no complaints about my hotel under the stars. We're almost as comfortable in our tent as the scorpion is in its burrow. Especially since Mr. Abdul is such a great cook. Since the beginning of time, desert people have tried to make the best possible use of the animals they raise and the plants they grow around their oasis. Scorpions, too, are grateful for any food the desert offers. These dauntless hunters aren't so fussy about their food. Everything that falls into their clutches becomes a meal. Scorpions eat about